Welcome to the second tutorial for ViperOne. This time we're going to try to land using the ILS system. First we need to check the mission. We're going to use a normal landing. Let's start. Let's change first the radar range to about 10 miles. As you can see, the we'll also change the ILS system, change the add display to ILS system. We have multiple choice, CCRP, NAV, and ILS. The runway is again 9 miles away in front of us, as shown by the localizer ILS blue line, vertical blue line, telling us we're pretty close to being right on the money. The horizontal line, blue line of the ILS is the glide slope. We also kind of nice riding that glide slope, but we're way too fast, so we're gonna start by braking, opening the air brake, and also reducing the throttle to minimum idle. We are now at 7 miles away at about 2,500 feet, descending at a point, it's moving around, but around 1,000 feet per minute. This is an indication of the sink rate. Minus is being going down, and K meaning it's thousands of feet, per minute. The most important part here is to watch your angle of attack and your indexer. This is way too low, so what we're going to do is we're going to pitch up a little bit in order for us to get the gun cross, this green cross here, which is the actual nose of the plane. This is where nose is located, to the 10 degree pitch up altitude. We are nicely still on the guide slope. We're going to change the radar range to 5 so we can see what's going on. We are here just approaching the runway, about 5 miles away. We are way, I forgot that we are way too slow, so we need to increase quite a bit, maybe closing the air brake. It's hard to talk and fly an F-16, as you can imagine. So our speed is going up and our angle of attack is going down, which is a little bit, we're gonna push down to go back to 10 feet. Okay, now we are better. We're gonna reduce a little bit. We're back to the 13 degree angle of attack. We're about now 4 miles away and about 1 minute to landing. This is the time to landing. 1,000 feet, 13 degrees, we're in good shape. As you can see, that also important is that little, now it's behind the line, but this is the about 3 degrees pitch down. This is basically, if your flight path is on that line, this right here, this green little line, dotted line, is your minus 2 degrees glide slope. This means that if your flight path is on that line, it means you're going down 3 degree down a glide slope, which is usually what you want to do, is getting down to a three degree minus 2 degree glide slope. We're going a little bit up, so we're gonna reduce the throttle a little bit. As you can see, the flight path is much higher than this minus 3 degrees glide slope, and you're gonna going down now. We're gonna wait until we get to 13 degrees, and then or so the two important thing to watch is the you can cross about 10 degrees and your flight pass around minus 3 degrees pitch. Also to watch that you want to land with less than minus 1,000 feet per minute sink rate. You can see it's 13 degrees, not bad. The gear pull down and the message gear is shown here. This happened automatically at 500 feet, when you reach 500 feet down. You can see that 13 degrees is fine still. We are about 330 feet and going down to 0.6 to 0.9 feet per thousands feet, actually 600 feet per second, per minute, sorry. The speed is okay, but we don't care because this is really important, is the angle of attack looks good. We just reached the threshold of the runway. We lost the ILS because we're very close, and we are 0.3, 0.4 miles inside the runway, and you can see that it's red, meaning that you are flying over the runway. You want to land when this is red. If the range is white, then it means you're outside the runway. We are 50 feet. We're kind of low on the thing, so we're on the angle of attack. So we're going to, I guess too late now. It's okay. We're going to reduce the threshold, the throttle to minimum idle, so that we can brake. And you can see the nose of the plane is at 10 degree up, meaning that you're using the F-16 body to do the braking as well. I forgot to turn on the air brake as well. And you can see that the nose of the plane is going down slowly as your speed goes down. It just means that the speed going down, you have less lift from your the body of the F-16. And you can hear the brake making noise. Hopefully, I guess we are, that's an already good landing because we passed the runway. Not much, but we still passed the runway at least 0.2 mile, on about 1200 feet. But it's okay for this tutorial, that's good enough. The main thing is we landed about 12 degrees, which is not bad. 13 is better, but we definitely landed outside the runway, and you can see that the landing distance is pretty high. The landing, this is wrong. This is should be reading 12, but we'll fix that later. That's about it. Thank you.